In this video, we will compare the three procedures that are performed for weight loss. Gastric band versus gastric sleeve versus the Roux gastric bypass. As shown in the cartoons over here, you can see the gastric band, which as the name suggests is wrapped around the upper part of the stomach, causing a very small gastric pouch and a small opening controlled by a valve mechanism. This procedure has fallen out of favor. However, it is not entirely irrelevant. Gastric sleeve is the commonest procedure performed these days in the United States. It converts the stomach into a tube, thus reducing the volume tremendously. The gastric bypass is the second commonest operation, where the stomach is partitioned, leaving the greater part of the stomach redundant, with a small pouch at the top connected to the small bowel. Not only is there a small stomach, however, a fair part of the small bowel is no longer available to absorb the food, hence the malabsorption also contributes to weight loss. In terms of mortality, the safest procedure is the gastric band, where mortality is exceedingly rare. The gastric sleeve and the gastric bypass are also very safe operations, and a patient dying is a very rare event, such as 1 in 1,000. In terms of complications, yet again, the early complications, gastric band is again the safest, followed by gastric sleeve. The gastric bypass is not too far behind. In terms of late complications, this is a year and after the operation, gastric sleeve is the safest operation, followed by gastric bypass, and it is the late complications that let down the gastric band. Now looking at durable weight loss, this is weight loss at 1, 3, 5 and 7 years after the operation. Over here, the gastric bypass seems to have the edge, where 70% of excess weight loss is maintained over the long term, closely followed by the gastric sleeve operation. The gastric band fails in this assessment. In terms of the failure rate, that is not achieving the target weight loss, the best operation with the highest success rate again is the gastric bypass, followed by the gastric sleeve, and the gastric band loses out yet again. Type 2 diabetes. Early type 2 diabetes, the success rate for the gastric bypass and the gastric sleeve is about equal. 2/3 up to 70% of the patients go into remission. The success rate with gastric bypass is not as high in this situation. In terms of brittle or severe diabetes that is difficult to control, the winner here is the gastric bypass operation, followed closely by the gastric sleeve, and the gastric band is not as effective in this situation. So which of these operations are reversible? So over here, the gastric band is fully reversible and the band could just be removed but requires another surgical procedure. The gastric sleeve is not reversible because part of the stomach is removed. The gastric bypass may be reversed but requires another complex operation to achieve that. What adjustments are required once the initial procedure is performed? This is the highest in the gastric band, where the gastric band may be required to be inflated or deflated under radiological guidance. And this, of course, is not the case with the other two surgical procedures. In terms of reoperations, the gastric band here fails. It may not achieve its initial purpose. And also there is a high rate of erosion requiring removal of the gastric band over the long term. Reoperations for the gastric sleeve are less common when compared to the gastric bypass. Typically for the gastric sleeve, it is the reflux or development of new reflux that may require conversion of gastric sleeve to gastric bypass, whereas in the gastric bypass over the long term, small bowel obstruction due to the layout of the small bowel may require reoperations. Patients who've had previous abdominal surgery, gastric sleeve may be more suited to these patients, followed by the gastric band, and because of the complexity of the gastric bypass operation, it may not be suitable for some patients if they had previous bowel surgery involving the small bowel. In terms of learning speed, the gastric band has been found to be the quickest that is taken up by the surgeons, followed by the gastric sleeve, and the gastric bypass takes a little bit longer to master. Now let's look at individual indications. So the very obese with a BMI of greater than 50, the gastric bypass is the best procedure to produce the most optimum outcomes, followed by the sleeve gastrectomy. Gastric band is not as successful. In adolescents, where reversibility and short-term weight loss is an option, gastric band is the best operation to perform over here. where once the objectives are achieved, then this can be taken out and the procedure is completely reversible. Those patients with reflux, the best operation is the gastric bypass operation, because the small gastric pouch reduces or eliminates any prospect of reflux occurring. The gastric sleeve is contraindicated and should not be performed in patients with reflux disease, and the gastric band is moderately successful in this situation. However, the reflux comes back once the gastric band is removed. In patients who've had previous fundoplication for reflux, as previously explained, the best operation is the gastric bypass because it eliminates the process. Gastric sleeve should not be performed in these patients, and gastric band is not durable. Factors highlighted in this video are backed by research evidence, which I shall try and append to the description. This ends this brief video. If you have any comments, please do share.